I thank the sponsor for yielding to this question, and as was mentioned previously by many of my colleagues, we will have a long and protracted, hopefully not too protracted, 2 weeks here in Albany where we hash out the budgets and do the work for the people that we represent on both sides of the aisle. As you know, Mr. President, I'm a huge proponent of music, and this reminds me of a 1993 song by Tupac Shakur, Keep Your Head Up, where he said, we got money for war but can't feed the poor. And quite literally, if you look in this resolution, you have $200 million for expenses that can be used to, in case of a war, but we cut breakfast after the bell, Mr. President. My Brother's Keeper initiatives, we were the first state in the entire nation to take President Obama's challenge on for My Brother's Keeper. And while I understand the sponsor's information about the foundation name, My Brother's Keeper is essential to ensuring that black and brown children have just as large of a chance of success. The Tenant Protection Unit is vital in the city of New York. It is vital. It keeps people in their homes and it penalizes bad landlords. This is something that we need to fund. Many of my colleagues are going to speak about NYCHA, so I will speak briefly on it and understand that public housing is intended to protect those of us who have the least. And if basic shelter is something that we need and that we require, we have to actually put the money into the budget as opposed to simply just saying that we're going to do something about it. It's a step, but it's not all the way where we need to be. And concerning criminal justice reform, it's about fairness, Mr. President. We are not looking to have a defense bar-laden work product, nor do we want a prosecutorial-heavy work product. We want criminal justice to be fair in the state of New York. In speedy trial, bail, and discovery have to be in this budget. You know, Mr. President, I this is my second budget in my first term, and I look at it as a work in progress, and I'm confident that we will continue to work together, but as currently constructed, this is insufficient, and go back to what Tupac would say. He said it, there ain't no hope for the future, but I believe there is hope. And I hope that we can work across the aisle on this one. Thank you, Mr. President.